Hey, welcome in everybody. In this video, I'm gonna go about trying to create this part. So I got this part from www.studycadcam.com. So they have a lot of great exercises over there that you can practice. You can download and practice on your own. But I found this one and I'm gonna give this one a shot. So this one is 3D exercises 1143. So it has like, it looks like a little corner piece, where it has some angles here and there's some circles kind of centered in some walls on the floor. So I'm gonna go about and try to demonstrate how to create this. But as always, you wanna try to create these on your own first. And then if you get stuck, then you can kind of, you know, kind of see how I did it or see how somebody else did it by just watching videos. So anyway, I'm gonna stop yapping and let's get down to business. So I'm gonna go to my Inventor. And what I want to do is I'm going to start a new metric standard. I'm going to click on the create button. And then I'm going to start a 2D sketch. For this one, I'm going to use this flat plane here. And I want to rotate this 90 degrees to the left. So my cube, my view cube shows top, kind of reading the way it should. And then I'm gonna start laying out kind of like the top view of this particular part. So I'm gonna use my line tool. I'm gonna start here at the origin. I'm gonna draw this over. I'm just gonna draw the basic shape at first. I'm not gonna worry about dimensions. I'm gonna try to get it kind of close, but you know, not really exact. So I'm gonna come over to the right. And I really didn't want that little, I don't know why it does that to me. I don't want this curvy gobbledygook. All right, let's do this. So I drew a line to the right. Hopefully you don't get that little curvy piece like I did. And I'm gonna go up to the right this way. Then I'm gonna go straight up. Let me zoom out a little bit. I'm gonna go straight up a little ways. And then this angle here, I'm not sure what. I'm just gonna kind of create like this and like that. I'm gonna right click, hit okay. So yeah, that looks kind of wonky. So I'm gonna add some dimensions here to try to straighten this piece out. So I'm gonna dimension from this corner to this vertical. And they're telling me that's 75. And that threw us way out of whack, not a problem. And then I'm gonna dimension from here down to this flat piece here. That's gonna be 75. And we're up like so. And then what I want to do is I'm going to just drag this, click on this corner and move it back over a little bit. So this right here is going to be from here to here is 25. Is that right? Yeah, 20. Yeah. And then from here to here, that's also 25. So now we're looking a little bit better. So then, well, I think my next step is gonna be to draw a circle with a center point. I'm just gonna draw a random circle, just kind of somewhere over in here. And then I'm gonna dimension this. So this is gonna have a diameter of 30. And I'm gonna dimension the center. So from this vertical to the center of this circle, this is going to be 35. And then from the center down to this horizontal is gonna be 35. All right, so now I got something to work with. So now what I wanna do is I'm gonna draw like a construction line from the middle of this line through the center here. So I'm gonna go back to my line, look for that green dot. That tells me that that's the midpoint of this line here. I want to make another line from here, kind of straight up, kind of way past it here. So I'm going to turn these, both of these lines into a construction line this one. Probably this one's gonna be a center line, like so. And I wanna extend this up. Oh, I can't do it. I have to remove what? Okay. So, let me get rid of this. I'm gonna draw a line from the midpoint here. And let me just kind of draw it kind of out of whack there. I'm gonna do a constraint. I'm gonna use a coincident. So I want this center to be somewhere on this line. So it moves it over like that. So there we go. And then what I wanna do is now I'm going to change this back to my center line. All right, so I know that this edge or this corner is somewhere gonna be located somewhere along this line. I'm just not sure how far up or down. So again, I'm gonna use my, the coincident constraint. I'm gonna pick this kind of this intersection of this where these two lines meet and just kind of pick on this center line here. So now whenever I move this, it can move. I'm not sure what the angle is, but I know it's somewhere along this line here. All right, so my next step is gonna be, I'm gonna draw some more lines. So I'm gonna draw a line from this corner here. I'm just kind of draw it at some kind of an angle. It looks like the image. I'm not worried about the actual dimension here yet. I'm gonna draw another line from this corner. I'm gonna draw it at kind of an angle like so as well. And I'm gonna add a perpendicular constraint to these. So I'm gonna go to perpendicular. I'm gonna select these two lines. I'm gonna select these two lines. And so now what I can do is I'm gonna add this. So I know that this, from the angle from here to here, it tells me it's 60 degrees. I'm gonna measure it off the center line from here to here is gonna be 30. That's half of 60, right? So that's 30. Same thing from here to here is gonna be 30. Wait, I don't want that. I want the angle from here to here. There we go. So that's gonna be 30, and it already is, so I don't need that. I'm gonna cancel that. So by doing that, now it pulls pulls this kind of corner where it needs to be. And then what I can do is I can fillet this edge here, this corner, and it has a radius of, it says, what is that, 12? So I'm gonna go to fillet. And I want this to be 12. I'm gonna select this line and this line. I wanna offset this. This may offset the whole thing. Okay, that's what I want. All right, so I'm gonna offset that by 8. And I'm gonna make sure that this fillet, I wanna make sure that this radius here is 20, which it is, that should be 12, actually. That needs to be 12. Let me delete this. And I'm going to fillet, where is my fillet? Here. That needs to be 12. Yeah, that needs to be 12 as well. So here and here is 12, like that. I'm gonna trim this edge here. I don't need that. I don't need that. We're good there. All right, so I need a dimension from here to here. That's gonna be 8. You get the check mark. First, I wanna move these two out of the way because they're lined up with each other. I wanna move because they're two different. So this one is dimensioning to this. And this one is dimensioning to that, which I don't know. I kind of like it up here at the top, like so, maybe. I'd rather have this piece on the other side, but or this number on the other side, but it's okay. Okay, so the two dimensions that I need in order to constrain this, I'm just gonna wrap I create this construction line here. I'm just gonna select it and delete that. And then I need I need to dimension kind of how long this center line is, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to trim off this extra piece. So I'm going to go up to trim. I'm going to trim off this extension here. And now you can see that we're fully constrained in our sketch. So now what we can do is we can finish our sketch. I'm going to start extruding some of this. So I'm going to extrude the back part first. So I'm going to go to extrude. I'm going to click on this and this, and that's going to go up by 50 millimeters. And when I do this, our sketch is going to go away, but don't panic. So when I hit okay, notice our sketch is gone. So to get it back, I'm going to go up to where you see extrusion one, click the plus sign. I'm going to right click. I can either do a share sketch or turn on the visibility. I think I'll just click on share sketch. And now we get our dimensions back. We get our sketch back. So then I'm just going to extrude this piece, and it's not going to go up by 50. That's going to go up by 10, like so. And then now I can get rid of that sketch. I don't need that. So I'm going to right click. I'm going to turn the visibility off. So now all I have left to do is just kind of cut the holes through these back walls. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start a 2D sketch on this plane here. And I'm going to create a circle just somewhere on this surface. I'm going to dimension this diameter. The circle is going to be 20. And then I'm going to dimension from this edge to the center. That's going to be 30 from the center to this edge here. That is 20, like so. I can finish my sketch. I can extrude this circle. I'm going to cut it all the way through. Hit OK. I'm going to do the same thing to this surface here. So I'm going to go to start 2D sketch. Click this surface. I'm going to make a center point circle. I'm going to dimension. So that one is going to be 20 as well. So I'm just going to, instead of giving this a dimension, no, let me not do that. I'm going to go ahead and give it a dimension. 20. Then I'm going to dimension it from the center to this edge. That's 30 from the center to this edge here is 20. Finish my sketch. I'm going to extrude it, the circle. I'm going to cut it, so it's going to be a boolean cut. It's going to go all the way through, and hit okay. So there is our 1143. And then you can go up here if you want. You can add a material to it. I just really like adding textures or colors to it. So which one am I going to do? I'm just going to do something real quick. So maybe a smooth off-white. And then for visual style, shaded with edges. Shadows, reflections. You can do a perspective, which I think is the view that they have in the picture there. I can change my lighting to photo booth. Also, I want to show you how you can render this. So if I go up to environments and I'm going to click on Inventor Studio and click on render image. And what I usually do is for the size, I usually click this little select output size, and I'll click the very bottom one. I'll leave the current, the camera view where it is, like it is, the camera lighting, or current lighting, I can't read, the current lighting like it is. I'm going to output, click save rendered image, and then you're just going to give this a name, so I can say this is 1143. I think an important thing is where you see options, I'm going to click options, I'm going to change it from 96 to 300, and then I'm just going to click OK. And then for renderer, let me save this first. Now for renderer, I like to do until satisfactory. That's just going to keep rendering it until you kind of see it's good enough, like you like it. And then I'm going to click render. And you can let this go for a while if you want to. I'm not going to make you sit here and watch this whole thing, but I'll kind of pause the video and I'll show you what it looks like when, you know, when I'm satisfied. I mean, you could leave this here for days and days if you want it, but ain't nobody got time for that. So I'm going to pause the video and I'll kind of show you what the final outcome is. All right, so we're back. You can kind of see it looks a lot better now, but I'm at 380 some odd iterations and it's still going, but I'm just going to kind of stop it here. So I'm gonna hit the X. And then just to make doubly sure it saves it, I'm gonna click on the file save and save this thing again. So I'm gonna name this 1143. I'm gonna hit save. And I'm not really, you know, it doesn't really pop out for me. So I'm maybe probably gonna go back and redo this and color it blue, kind of like the original images. So I can click, hit the X. I can go to close. I want to finish Inventor Studio. I would probably go back up here and just look for a smooth, sky blue dark. That looks kind of cool, actually. I like that. So probably I would go back and re-render this a different color until I kind of get it the way I want it, but you kind of get the idea. So I hope that helps you create this part, and I'll see you back in the next lesson. Make sure you like and subscribe. All right, peace out.